and presented his findings compared to the Word of God, and one older, most revered scientist stood up and said, "I want a private audience with you after, and I would encourage my colleagues to listen." At the end of his speech, he said, if anyone else want to have a private audience and find out more of what it takes to know Jesus, write your name on a piece of paper. We'll pass this hat." Well, there was a frantic man because there's a lack of paper, you know, and they were having trouble finding out. It turned out that 90 out of 100 atheist scientists saw unrefutable, that's the word, truth, and asked Jesus to be our pastor. That is my prayer this morning as our musicians might come up and play some music as we close. That you realize the spiritual side, how real it is, and realize the truth. I can't tell you how many times I heard about Jesus and it bothered me. How many times I said, "Get out of my face." But there came a time when I realized, like this scientist, there was no other way. Seemed like everywhere I went, everybody knew his name. Jesus Christ. And they weren't saying it in reverence. I never heard anybody go around yelling Buddha to him. Or her. You know, I realized the truth, and I finally said yes. Would you bow your head in prayer with me right now? Heavenly Father, God, if you have someone here today that you've been talking to, and they know Lord of my life. My life is not what I would like it to be. I am not what I want to be. God, I pray this be the time for any decision that you would just burden their heart and say yes to you. In Jesus' name I pray. Every head bowed still. I would ask this morning if you know that it's time to say yes to Jesus, that you want to have that brand new life that He has for you, for your life and your family to have healing. Would you just lift your hand? He's been calling you all your life. He loves you. He's got a wonderful plan for your life. If you're a biker, He wants you to ride for Him. And you'll never experience such a greater joy, a greater sense of purpose. Just lift your hand. Just so I can say, nobody else can want to. Before I pray. If you're here this morning and you've said the prayer to ask Jesus in your heart, but you've not been living for Him, and you want to commit your life to Him right now, would you lift your hand? Anyone? There's some decisions you need to make. There's some changes you need to make to walk closer with God. You want to make that commitment today. Would you? Pray with me now if you're making this decision. Lord Jesus, come into my heart. Forgive me of my sin and make me the kind of person you want me to be. I believe that you died on the cross rose from the grave, proving that salvation is real, that you are alive. I believe that this morning. Come into my heart and into my mind. And Lord, from this day forward, I just want to walk closer to you than I walked before. Closer than I walked with you yesterday. But not as close as today.